So back in 2009, they came up with a comprehensive aquifer management plan of how can we fix this problem, not only to stop the drop in the aquifer, but actually potentially build it back up. And what that entails is taking water that would otherwise leave the state and that's not being used and put it back into the ground so where it can be used at another point in time. And it also helps increase the stream flows that come out of this aquifer. In looking at how to repair that, how to build that back up, and how can we do that the most efficiently? Well, the first off was partnering with the canal companies since that infrastructure was already built. The other part of it is we needed more capacity. How can we move more water off and get it into the aquifer? So then we had to develop new sites that weren't previously there. That's where our work with the BLM and that partnership has been crucial, because there's wide open areas. If we could get a canal and a natural basin that was already there, put headworks in there to get water into that basin, instant recharge site. And the amount of capacity that we've developed in just these sites has more than doubled what was there previously. Monitoring has been a key part of this. One is being able to follow where the water goes once it gets into the aquifer. Are we having the impact that we want? And another key concern is we don't want to negatively impact the water quality of the aquifer. A lot of people depend on this aquifer. In the 5 years that we've been doing this, basically there's been absolutely no impact to the water quality of the aquifer. For me, it's really exciting because when you look at all of that water is going in to repair the aquifer, and it's really gonna build the aquifer back up. And so not only stabilize all the uses that are happening now, but actually create water for the future as we move forward.
Milepost 31 recharge site has been one that's been being used for several years, beginning 2007. And this year is definitely the most use or most water I've seen in it so far. Because the canals have been in place since the early 1900s, IDWR and BLM were able to utilize those to lessen the new infrastructure and new disturbance footprint on the public lands.
So as Shoshone Field Manager, one of the things I like most about my job is the fact that we're a multiple use agency, and this is a great example of that. This is a project that I never would have dreamed of that walked in the door that we were fortunate enough to be able to work on and work with the Idaho Department of Water Resources on. Yeah, this has the potential to be a real legacy project that can benefit multiple generations for years to come.